Hey guys, I am Preeti and you are watching this video on why did I meet this person. So this person can be anybody. It can be somebody whom you have looked upon as a life partner or as a girlfriend, boyfriend or any other person, your friend or anybody like that. Okay, so here we will see why you have met this person. Okay, so in case if you have chosen this option, then we will go with this first. So how you have to do this reading? First of all, you have to focus on all the options. I will be showing you all the different options that are here. We have five options again. Out of all of these five options, you have to just focus upon each one of them. Then close your eyes and see which option pulls your attention, which option is attracting you. And you need to go ahead with that option. Okay, so yeah, just select one option. So in case if you have chosen this option, let's begin. I will be placing the timestamps below this video so you can go ahead and first select your option, then based on your option, go on the timestamp and watch the video. Okay, so let's begin. Okay, so if you have chosen this option, the cards say that there is going to be something new that is going to enter your life. Because of this person. Why you met this person? Because of this new person, you have some new energy is going to come into your life. See, whether you have this person as a committed partner or a life partner or a friend or anybody, this person may not be even connected with you now, but the reading goes for them. Okay, why they entered your life? Because first of all, they've had to bring a positive energy of a new endeavor towards you. Okay, so that's the first thing. The second thing I'd like to say, you know, this person actually taught to travel. You know, this person made you travel a lot, made you roam around a lot, which is why traveling has become your passion now. And in your endeavor, the endeavor that's coming up to you, that endeavor will require you to travel a lot. Okay, so this is why this person has come into your life. Then there is this one more thing that, okay, now there is this romantic relationship card. And even though this person stirred up some romantic feelings into your mind, yeah, they may not have been into a relationship with you. They did not come into your life to get into a marriage or get into a commitment. But they have stirred up the emotions, stirred up the romantic feelings in you. Maybe before this, you were not ready to get into a romantic relationship. But this person has brought this romantic feelings in your life. Okay, this person has reignited the want for a romantic relationship. Okay, and the next two cards again. Now I have three different decks that I have used here, and these two decks also, they say first of all that this person has brought in a lot of positivity. See, it may appear that that person was not that positive, that person, the relationship with that person was also not that great, but the person, that relationship, it has actually brought in a lot of positivity in your life. And allow sunshine to enter in your life, bask into the warm energy during sunrise and sunset using sun's energy. And there is a lot of light that is seen. The light that this person brings into your life, that is the light that you actually require to begin on this new endeavor. Okay, you need to follow your divine inner spark that will bring enrichment in your life. So this person actually brought light into your life so that you can start following your divine inner spark. Maybe before this, you were not actually knowing that you have a divine inner spark. You were not knowing that you have a spark and you need to follow it. You have a path and you need to follow it. Before that, you did not know that. But after the relationship, after you met this person, after you bumped into this person, things have become very clear. That person may or may not be in your life, but the cards say that, yeah, you know, there are a lot of chances that this person has just gone away from your life, or you just lost touch with this person, because to have a relationship with this person was not the ultimate goal. but this person was supposed to bring some light into your life, because of which this person entered in your life. Okay, see, all the three decks that I used to do this reading are pointing out towards the same thing. Again, there is one more card from this deck, and it says that clear endeavor means clearly it is an endeavor that's a new endeavor that's beginning, and it has come to you because of this person. Okay, and what you need to do is now you need to go ahead and walk on this path of the endeavor. Now, if I am doing this reading and you just feel that there is no endeavor coming in your life, let me say that there is an upcoming endeavor that you are supposed to embrace and start walking on it. At the same time, you also will start having this feeling of beginning a journey where you are doing something on your own. And this might be a very intense calling within you, and you might just feel, what is it that I have to do? What is it that I have to do? And you have to begin. You have to do the digging yourself about what it is that you need to do, that the endeavor that you need to build upon. Okay, and traveling will also help you. So travel or take a trip so that you can start learning what this new endeavor is and start working upon this endeavor. Okay, so yeah, so this is it for this reading, and I hope that you like it. Let me know in the comment box below, how did you like this reading? Okay, and let's go to the next option. You know, the final card in that option was about contemplation. I just forgot to talk about that. Contemplation is when you think about something, when you ponder over a thought for a long time, and you try to discover what it's trying to tell you. The same thing is about the endeavor, because when I say a new endeavor is beginning, or it's coming up, or it's you who has to begin, then you might see, if nothing is coming up from the external world, then it might make you ponder. And you need to ponder, you need to contemplate that what it is that you need to begin as a new endeavor. Okay, so see, it might take you some time. Okay, it's not going to, I don't say that it's not going to come easily, but the tip that I offer you here is, for the next 3 days, just at night, pray to your angels, gods, whosoever you believe in. Ask them to help you discover that endeavor, what that endeavor is that you need to start working upon. Okay, and you have to do it for the next 3 days. And the early morning, don't get into your mobile phone, don't get into anything else. And whatever thought pattern you have for the next 1 or 2 hours, you need to just note down your thought patterns. Okay, so yeah, that is going to help. Enough. If you have chosen this option, this is a beautiful angel, greenish black colored angel, and yeah, if you have chosen this, let's go ahead. So we are going to do about this reading about why this person entered your life. Okay, so first of all, let me say, you know, from all these cards that are being visible, see, now this reading can be about a person who is from whom you expected a committed relationship, a romantic relationship, or a marriage, or it can be even a friendship, colleague, etc., any relationship. But it can be that this person came into your life and he or she, they just went away, and maybe the relationship was short-lived, and maybe you just lost touch. So in that case, if you want to know what that person was supposed to, why did you meet that person? So let's see into that. First thing, you know, the cards say is there were lots of conflicts in your mind. Lots of conflicts in your mind, and it can be that you might have a conflict even with that person. Okay, you and that guy, that girl or the guy had a conflict, and there are certain relationships that you bring on so that certain energies you bring on in a relationship so that you can learn something. So this conflict you brought in so that that conflict, maybe that conflict, it brought to your notice that, okay, this person exists, and you might actually dreamt about having this person as your life partner, but it did not work out. Or when you were getting into the sky, when you met this person, you already were going through a breakup, and Yeah, this person may be going through a conflict, or you might be going through a conflict in your life, as well as you were going through a breakup in your life, and which is why you met this person, because your energies were so confused, your energies were so scrambled up that you required this person to come into your life. And this card says that you had just lost in touch. This card says that you just lost in touch with your real self, and in order to remind you of your real energies, this person came into your life. Okay, this person brought self-discipline and willpower into your life. And see, just in case you feel that this person did not do anything like that, see, this is the energy that you need to build upon now, because even though what energy that person brought in, it did not seem that good, it did not seem that positive, but once this person has come into your life, it is, you are supposed to get self-discipline, you are supposed to start building upon your willpower. Okay, and also this person was supposed to bring in healing energy into your life, and healing not in the case that you get healed out of some diseases or anything like that, but healing for the soul. Healing for the soul means when the soul is so troubled that the soul keeps attracting negativity, which I told you with these two cards, that you had a lot of conflicts in your life, you were going through a breakup or just loss of something, and you needed a lot of discipline in your life. See, because anybody in this world is not supposed to suffer forever. You were suffering for some time and it was time for you to transform, which is why this person came into your life. This person brought in healing energy for your soul. Even though, see, their energies, even though how they behaved might not seem like healing behavior, okay? They might not be healers, their behavior might not be like that of a healer, or as if they're trying to heal you. Their behavior might not be like that, but they have come to heal you. And, you know, let me tell you that the past struggles that you have had, those past struggles made you so dark and gloomy that you actually forgot to enjoy your life. And this person has come to teach you. This person had or has come to teach you that you are supposed to enjoy the little luxuries in life. And just accepting pain. They wanted that you don't just keep indulging in pain. You also can attract a lot of pleasures and positivity in your life. The same thing is with these two cards. This card says that you need to start amplifying your positive emotions, which is why this person has come into your life. And you also start appreciating, you start having gratitude towards your life, which is important. A lot of times when people go through a lot of negativities, they feel that life is bad, and until and unless something good doesn't happen, they will just keep on complaining, or they will just keep on narrating their gloomy story. But it's not the case. This person has come into your life to teach you about being grateful and having appreciation for whatever you have in life. So just in case if you feel that you are not appreciating what you have, you're not grateful, then these are the changes that you need to start making. First, develop good self-discipline, develop good willpower. And yeah, the next thing is you need to focus on healing your mind, body and soul. Now you may have questioned that, okay, now how do I have willpower? How do I heal my mind, body, soul? You just have to get into this, that 3-day ritual, okay? 3-day bedtime ritual is at bedtime. Just try to pray that, how can I bring healing through my mind, body and soul? And then just go to bed, just pray this to your God, angels, whomsoever you believe in. And the next day, you will have this, early in the morning, you will have some thoughts or some feelings, whatever you have, you just have to write it down. Okay? And it's important to remember that in the morning, you don't get into any other mobile or television or newspaper. Okay? But first, you need to work upon this. The 3 days you have to allot totally to discovering this healing process. Okay? And so this is it. And amplify your positive emotions. And they might have taught you that just cribbing over what has gone bad doesn't help. You also need to amplify your positive emotions. And how are you going to amplify positive emotions? By focusing on the positive things in your life, by being grateful towards the good things in your life. Okay, so that is it for this option. And now let's go to the next option. Okay, so if it is this option that you have chosen, then let's go ahead with the reading. Okay, so for this option, the cards say that, okay, this, why did this person come into your life? The first thing this person came is to help you towards your path of enlightenment. Now you may say, okay, now I'm not into enlightenment, I don't want to enlighten myself. So in that case, I'd like to say every human being is supposed to get into enlightenment, whether you want it or not. So that is what you are searching for. Okay, and this person came into your life so that you can, your path towards enlightenment can begin. And also, you will have joy, contentment and gratitude. This person taught you to have joy, to have more contentment and be grateful for what you have. And they might have taught you to celebrate. They might have taught you to enjoy the pleasures that you have now. Okay? The second thing the cards say is the magician. The magician is supposed to, the magician is here to manifest magic in your life. So this person was like a magician to you, and magician in the sense, whatever you are supposed to do in life, whatever you are supposed to bring into your life, this person was supposed to just create that magic, just bring that alchemical energy in your life so that you can start building upon and manifest whatever you're supposed to manifest. Again, the next card is, this person taught you to enjoy your luxuries, and it may also, this also points out that they made you spend a lot of money that you had, but yes, they taught you to enjoy the little luxuries in life. And yes, so also have to get successful, this person taught you. You know, this from all of these cards, it also shows that they were here to bring a shift in your life, a shift that you have to make, a shift that you have to do. This shift can be a shift in your house or shift from one place to another. It can be even shifting abroad, and yeah, or shifting of your home or your office. If in any case, if you feel that you are not healed and you are traumatic, you have some emotions that you need to deal with, then back flower remedies are really good, and with back flower remedies you will be able to heal your emotions and your mind. Okay, so this is what the cards say. The next thing the cards say, yeah, again this shifting your energy thing, and yeah, so let the positive energy, see, maybe you might have felt some romantic feelings towards this person, you might have felt some very heartfelt emotions for this person, but maybe this person was not interested, they just moved away, or things just did not work out. But the cards say that they had come into your life to help you to learn, accept this energy, learn to accept the energy of your heart. And it is okay, it is okay that you feel good for somebody, it is okay that you have feelings for somebody and things don't work out. Still, the feelings that you had for them, they are still pure, right? So in universe, it's everything that you expect is not supposed to work out the way you want it. But even if something doesn't work out, you still are aware of this fact that the emotions that you had for this person were always pure, right? So it's okay to accept your emotions, and now you can just be okay with your emotions, and you need to shift your energy. So try to get into back flower remedies if you feel that shifting your emotions is very difficult. And so this is it what the cards have to say. And yes, so also keep on enjoying the luxuries. It doesn't mean that you have to spend a lot of money. Yeah, this person might have made you spend money in order to realize how fun it is to have a luxurious life, how it is good to enjoy the pleasures of life. But this person has come to taught you that, but this person has not come to waste your money. Okay, so in that case, if you think that, okay, you can spend some money at certain times, then you can spend it, but it's always not necessary to spend money to enjoy pleasures. Okay, sometimes the pleasures can come from something that's invaluable. Okay, so this is what the cards are supposed, this is what the cards are saying. And okay, so let's begin with the next option. Let me know down in the comment box below, how did you feel this option went for you? Okay, if you had chosen this option, then let's go ahead with this reading. So the first thing this person came into your life for is to bring you out from your resting mode, okay? And or they also came to help you to take rest. You were somebody who were just getting too much worked out, and you were somebody who were just getting drained of energy. This person came into your life to help you realize that you need to take a vacation, you need to take some rest and allow some more time to decide, just have some good time, be with yourself and ponder over something that you feel needs to be pondered. And yeah, the second thing this person taught you is, this person also taught you to save more money. Okay, so this person might have been somebody who might be very stingy with money, they might not spend money that easily. So, but yes, they help you, they came to help you to save money, deal with money in a more wiser manner. And also, they also taught you to take care about people around you, right? Deal with challenges in a kind and understanding manner. They also taught you to deal with challenges in a better manner, right? Because you were somebody who were just getting intimidated by challenges and you always like were lost at that game. But the cards here say that you are somebody who is learned to deal with challenges in a better manner with this person's presence. Okay, so this is why that person came into your life. Also, you know, this relationship can be somebody, this relationship was like going to, it was supposed to be like a committed relationship, a good life partner kind of relationship. Or if it's like a person whom you are not expecting a commitment, or if it's just like a friend or a neighbor or a colleague, then it was meant to be like a very good and close relationship, a close friendship. But actually, you just did not, you were not able to deal with it at that time, or maybe the relationship might not be anymore, but this person may be still around you, you might not be in touch, and the positive resolution of a conflict. So if there was any conflict with this person, so it can be that this person's the conflict with this person will come to an end and your relationship can grow more closer. Okay, so see, just in case that this person is not somebody from whom you expect a life partner sort of relationship, then this person has come to you so that you can start growing closer to your life partner, or start getting closer to finding your life partner. Okay? And also, this person came to teach you that you need to learn from your mistakes and take steps that you never make them again. And yeah, so life doesn't have eraser for the wrongdoings in life. So same thing, this person came to teach you that whenever you are wrong, it is not necessary that you will be able to make it right. Life doesn't have an eraser, right? So, but you will be able to improve that mistake such that you don't make it again. And this person has taught you to come out of your ego, okay? This person has taught you to come out of ego and not treat people egoistically, so that you are more positive in any situation, you are positively helping people in any situation, okay? So look into the situation carefully without being overly positive or negative. So this person has taught you to come out of your ego and start observing things, people and situation from a third person point of perspective. The next thing the cards are saying is, this person has also come to your life to make you realize that you need to clear off the old, because because of this first option that we had here, that you need to rest, you need to take vacation, it means that you might have gathered a lot of debris from your past relationship and past relationship, past experiences, past friendships. This person has come to teach you that you need to clear off all of that that does not serve your purpose. And yeah, so clear out the old. So anything that is old and does not fulfill its purpose of enlightening you and making you grow, then you need to clear that out. You know, unless and until you don't clear out, you might actually be vulnerable. Okay? Also, one more thing. This person has also taught you that being vulnerable sometimes is okay. Before, what happened is you kept on piling up on negative energy because you just felt that negative energy was going to be a sort of shield for you so that you don't get vulnerable. But it's not that negative energy cannot shield you. It cannot protect you. But once you are clear, once you have cleared off that negativity, once you are out of that negativity, it's okay to be vulnerable. And it's not a weakness, because at times everybody is vulnerable up to some extent or another. Okay? So yeah, so this is the option for you. Now let's get ahead with the next option. Now if you have chosen this option, this one, then let's go ahead. Now there are a lot of things that are coming from this is, you know, meeting this person, it might have been like a roller coaster of a journey, because things might have turned upside down and you might have begun experiencing a lot of negativity in your life. Or maybe it was that you were already experiencing negativity in your life, you were having a lot of discontentment, and you were just, things were just standstill when this person came into your life. Okay, but yes, from overall all of these cards, I do feel that because of this person's entry, there is a lot of negative energy, a lot of negative emotions that you have felt, and all of that is because of karma. You can see that maybe it was your past karma that has now this person, as soon as you met this person, that past karmic baggage has been triggered, and all of that negative energy that was trapped inside that karmic baggage has all engulfed your entire life, and not entire life but your present life in general. And okay, now this card says that your truth, when you accept your truth and speak it out, self-respect will be gained. So one thing that appears from all these cards is you may be, see, now because of all the negativity that I can see, you may have been somewhere not accepting that it can be even your fault. Because see, whenever karma is involved, people usually feel, oh, I did not do anything like that. But in past, something you did that actually brought in that karmic baggage, right? So you cannot deny it. But at the same time, now you don't have to go and verbally tell everyone that, hey, I have this bad karma and it has messed up my life. You don't have to say that, okay? But at times, whenever you feel that it's your fault, you can actually accept it. You can speak your truth. See, speaking your truth in this situation, especially when this appears that a lot of negativity is happening in your life, at that time, speaking the truth can be a challenge. It can be a very huge, like, yeah, scary thing. But the card says that if you speak the truth and you will just balance your throat chakra, and your life will get balanced slowly. Okay, the second thing is you are not open, you have not, you have actually closed your heart chakra, maybe because of this person, and maybe because of this person, in past life you made this person suffer, which is why maybe they had closed their heart chakra in the past life. Now when it is the time that you triggered the past baggage, your heart chakra is balanced in that person's presence. Okay. And yeah, so that can be the case. Plus, the cards say that culmination of vision. So you need to, the culmination of vision, this card, it says that there are chances that you can actually see only negativity. You can actually see only negativity when you are in presence of this person or presently in your life. You can just see every negative point, or maybe when you watch this video, this can be the highest point of negativity that you might have actually experienced in your entire life. But the cards say that you can actually see the dark time. Dark times are something that can erase away. Dark times are surely going to fade away whenever the light appears, and the darkest hour is before the dawn, right? So that you have to remember. Culmination of vision. It also says that this person has also come into your life or had come into your life to teach you to learn the highest degree of anything. Okay, if you actually focus on something and you try to study it by continuously gazing at it, you will be able to realize what that thing is, how it is supposed to be used. The same thing is with person, with people. If you gaze upon a person for long, you will be able to know their characteristics and what they are, etc. Okay, so yeah, that can happen. Okay, so this is the reading for why you met this person. And see, this person is supposed to bring a new opportunity in your life, a new career advancement, change your life. Okay, so all of this negativity that you actually opened up to, or these negativities were already there in your life, but this person has come into your life so that you can begin the exciting new opportunity. Now, just in case if you don't have a new opportunity in your life, you might say, okay, what is there for me? The thing is that you can actually start building up an opportunity for yourself, and you can change your life in that case. And the same thing can appear with your Vishuddhi chakra. The more truthful you will appear, the strength, the inner strength will increase. And you also need to open your heart. How can you open your heart chakra? You can open your heart chakra with heart chakra stones, okay, rose quartz and aventurine. So yes, so this is the reading for this. And let me know down in the comment box below, how did you like this reading? And let me know what other readings you would like to see with the pick a card reading options. Okay, so yeah, so that is it for this week's reading. We'll see you again in my next video. Until then, keep following the path of your soul's purpose, because you are born for a reason. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye. Make sure that you subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon. When you click on the bell icon, select all notifications so that you get notified about all the videos that I upload.